Hello everyone, welcome to the HSPF training by DSI. This is Anurag Mishra. We are in the course HSPF 400. In this course, we learn how to do hydrologic calibration for an HSPF model. In this video, HSPF 410, we'll set up HSPXE Plus for hydrology calibration for an HSPF model. So we'll look at the UCI file that we developed during the video 330, and I just renamed the files and everything so that it's consistent with the course name. And one of the things that I want to point out is that for HSPXE Plus, I made sure that all of these names, especially this name of the WDM file and the UCI file, is 8 characters or less. Okay, so now let's look at, try to find the observed data. So we'll open basins. Okay, so in basins, if you remember that we earlier when we downloaded the data, the NVIS station, that is the USGS stations, that shapefile also got downloaded, and these are the two locations where we have observed data available. Not we have the NVIS has the data, so we have to download it now. So we'll make sure that NVIS station is selected here. Then we click on select, click here, and now this is the station for which we will download the flow data. Go to file, download data. So since we have that NVIS station selected, we have now the daily discharge option available. Click on download. Now it's going to download it in a new WDM file, but what we will do is, since we made the model already, what we'll do is we'll download this data in that WDM file. So go to browse and just be a 400. And the WDM file, that is the snake 410.wdm, where the output from this snake level watershed model is coming. So that is what it is going into there. Click on save. So now I click OK. So then basins will download the data from the internet, and it's available here. And if you remember this form from before, this is the form where it shows where all the data is, time series data. Let's click at it and let's look at what data is there. Analysis list. So this shows me the data for all the both files. So there's another attribute, data source. I'll click on this to make sure only the latest one is selected. And it has 1, 2, 3, 4 data sets with IDs 1, 101, 102, 103. This is the location. The location name is the same as the NVIS ID. And I can go ahead and look at star ID, or sometimes it is the station description. So it's a discharge cubic feet per second, and star name, so station name. So that's Snake River near Pine City. And data from 1913 to 2020 is available in this WDM file. Today is August 13, so data until yesterday is available. Click on cancel because we have the data already. One more thing we want to look at is that in our model, this reach corresponds to this observed data. So I want to know what is the number of that reach. Click on here, select that shapefile, click on identify, click here, it's the 54th reach. Okay, now we can save this project, close it. And we'll now open WinHSPF. Open that model. Okay, now this is the same UCI file in text format, same UCI file in HSPF format. So what we'll do is we'll go to Output Manager and Hydrology Calibration. We click on Add, and we say that the reachless 54th operation in the UCI file corresponds to this observed data. So this is the same as this thing. We want all the data sets that will be added to start as 541, 542. So I just say the base WDM DSN is 540. So now all the time series that will be added for 54 will have 541, 542. It's just for consistency, just for easy to remember. You can do whatever here. Click on OK. Close. Save. And we just want to run it to make sure that all the data is consistent. So all the new data sets that were prepared by WinHSPF, so all of them will get some value that way. Let's quickly look at this UCI file, what changes were done. You can do the comparison using the WinMerge or some file comparison tools. But if you see, this copy operation has been added, and we can talk about it later. And we have this, these time series added. 541, remember we gave the WDM base WDM DSN as 540. 541 is the flow volume, SYNQ is the flow volume. The top one, Hyder row, is the flow rate. Row flow, row wall is the flow volume, and you can check it in the HSPF manual how these two different time series are different. I would recommend you to look at that. This factor actually converts the value in inches. So all the flow volume that is here, that flow volume is divided by the area, so that we could get these the SYNQ in inches per unit time step. So this would be inches per day. And similarly, all of these are converted. And there's some there's additional feet to inch conversion. That's why there's a difference of 12 here. Anyway, so all of these surface runoff, intraflow, active groundwater, potential evapotranspiration, actual evapotranspiration, upper zone storage, lower zone storage, and moisture supply. All of these time series are added and now output by the HSPF model in the same WDM file. So let's look at the WDM file now. So if you see attributes, I'll just add ID also. Say 54 was already there, and 54 SYNQ, SURO, all of these files are there. Let's cancel this. It also created a file called EXS file, and we can just look at it in VS Code. And I would recommend you to spend some time and read this. It basically tells export system that what are the different time series there, what are the storms, and it calculated the storms based on the observed data, and it goes through some algorithm for that. And I would recommend you to do your own due diligence, and what is the area in acre, all of those math is done here. Summers is June, July, August. Winters is December, January, February. For a place like Minnesota, I would add March also in there. Okay, so this EXS file is called basin specification file. And if you were doing calibration in multiple location, multiple files like this will be created. So now let's run HSPXP+. So this is HSPXP+. I already installed and downloaded it. Downloaded and installed it. and I provided a link to this HSPXC Plus. Okay, so this is a simple browse button. Go to the UCI file, open it. There are multiple checkbox here. HSPXC Plus has a pretty good user manual, and I would recommend you to look at it. Run model. When I say run model, HSPXC Plus comes with its own version of HSPF, which is similar to the latest one, so that it can run HSPF model on its own. And we want hydrology calibration statistics. Sometimes we may want this date to be different than the model UCI date, so then we can change it. Let's click on start. So what HSPXC Plus did is that it ran HSPF model and then did some statistics. And this is the folder where it had produced bunch of files. And it is important for you to look at it, understand what all of these files mean, so that you can then use that information to actually edit the parameter to get the results that you want. I just very quickly go through it. So the first one that I'd like to start with is expert system stats, because it gives me a very quick overview of where I am. And remember, this is the first run, so I've not done anything, any calibration. So this is the total observed runoff was 23 inches, simulated is 7.4. So that means we are way under predicting. It's 11 inches, so this is per year. And this is the errors. So we want this error to be 10% or less. So these are, this is the first one I look at all the time. And these are the graphs it generates. So what I will do is, in the next video, I will go through, as you can see, this is a horrible calibration. But what I will do in the next video is I'll just go through all these files to explain what it means. My objective is not necessarily here to tell you how to calibrate or what parameters to change, but just so that you could see and look at, see which file can give you what information and how you can use it. So that's it for this video. We'll see you in the next one. Thank you.